Hi everyone, welcome to Fin Cocktail. Our previous video on savings rules got so much love that we thought we'll make another one on personal finance rules.
So personal finance can be a difficult and intimidating subject, right? So we thought that we'll share some of our favorite thumb rules to make this little simpler for you guys.
Absolutely, so let's dig in.
Before we move ahead, don't forget to like and share our video, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon.
Okay, so bear with me. We've been through this one, but it's the most important benchmark for savings rules. So we have to go over it again. It's the 50-30-20 rule. It states that no more than 50% of your monthly income should go towards needs, no more than 30% towards wants, and the rest 20% should go towards saving and investing.
But how do you account for these three separate categories? A fantastic way of doing it is to have three separate accounts for each of these: your needs, your wants, and saving and investing. For example, everybody has an account in which their salary gets credited each month. So this account can primarily be used for your needs. So you should keep 50% of your money in this account, and the balance can then be transferred via auto debit into two separate accounts, one for your wants and one for saving and investing.
The second account that you maintain can be your Ayashi account. So basically all the spending that you need to do to maintain your lifestyle go through this account. It includes everything: your shopping, your traveling, your eating out, the grooming sessions or mani-pedi, all of it. And if money runs out of this account, too bad, don't have any more. This will help you keep your spending in check and make you behave a little.
Last but not the least, and the most important, your savings and investing account. Now here, you can try to get a good savings rate for this account. Also keep in mind to link your SIPs or your other online investments through this account so that they happen seamlessly.
Another interesting personal finance rule is the 28-36 debt rule. What this does, it helps you maintain a DTI, which is a debt to income ratio. It also helps mortgage lenders decide whether they can give you a home loan or not and what rate they can give it to you at. It's a great way to figure out if you're overspending on your living expenses. Also, very important to keep in mind in case you're looking to buy or refinance a property.
The 28-36 rule basically states that a household should not spend more than 28% of their gross household income on household expenses and no more than 36% on other debt. 28% housing. This basically consists of your EMIs, your property taxes, and your insurance. You have to make sure that this number is at or below 28% of your gross income. For example, if you're earning 1 lakh rupees a month, then no more than 28,000 should be allocated towards these expenses. 36% of all other debt. This basically includes anything from your car loan, personal loan, student loan, or even your credit card debt. Going back to our previous example, if you're earning 1 lakh rupees a month, you should not allocate more than 36% to all your other debt.
Last but not the least, the car loan rule. So this rule has gotten a lot of love on Instagram, and we're going to try to explain it a little bit in detail. It's the 24-10 car loan rule. So imagine, नई गाड़ी होगी, friends को घुमाने में कितना मजा आएगा, right? Wrong. Friends आने वाले EMI pay करने के लिए, नहीं ना? Well, it's very common to overspend on buying cars. Now, why is that? Because you forget that along with just the car purchase price, you have stamp duty, registration, insurance, blah 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 behind it. So the 24-10 car loan rule can help you curb the spending.
It's a rule that will help you figure out which car you can afford technically. It's not like you can backtrack this calculation. Can I buy a 20 lakh rupee car with only a 5 lakh rupee annual income? It's going to tell you just that you can't really afford this. It might just be better to build your wealth rather than taking on such a huge loan.
So what this rule states is that you should put up at least 20% towards down payment. You shouldn't take on a loan with a tenure more than 4 years, and you shouldn't spend more than 10% of your gross income on its EMIs. Now, each of these numbers has a reason behind it. Now, why the 20% down payment? Gaadi showroom se nikli nahi aur uski value down. It's a highly depreciating asset. You don't want to end up with something that's worth less than what you owe. So at least 20% down payment. Now why the 4-year tenure? Minimizing the amount of interest that you pay can be done by approximately reducing the loan tenure to 4 years, 10%. Now, why this figure? Keeping your monthly car loan payments to under 10% of your monthly gross income won't put too much undue pressure on you to make these payments. Now, if your car or your car loan doesn't fit these parameters, time to find a car that does. Find one that's within your budget or wait a few months. Build up that wealth so that you can afford that car of your dreams. But don't make this decision in haste or to impress anyone.
Thoda technical ho gaya na. Sorry, what to do? Saving and budgeting can get exhausting. But like everything else, technology has made it far simpler. Now there are apps that you can download that can help you keep a track of your spending, budgeting, and also automate your savings and help you save some money. So why don't you take a look at these and take it from there. So ab convince ho gaye ya hum aur bolein?